Hey guys, what's going on? This is Adam Everett Miller for AETutsPlus.com, and in today's tutorial, we're going to look a little bit at tracking and then also how to create some cool looking veins. We're going to be kind of sucking the mutant power out of our poor chap that's stuck in the hospital. Initially, this shot was meant to be more positive, where you know a healing touch comes in and heals this guy from cancer. And so this is the source footage. The touch happens. That wasn't his hand. It was someone else's hand, but you get the idea. And so I had set up the shot originally, and I had kind of some healing effects, but I thought that the going a little bit more of a dark approach would be a little bit more fun. So so first thing that we want to do to our shot is we want to track it. So we'll head over to Mocha, and I already had it set up, but I'll just go ahead and import the footage again. Alrighty. And here we are. And over replace that. Okay, great. Remember in Mocha, if you hold down X, you can move around, and Z will allow you to zoom in or out. And what we want to track is you notice as the shot progresses, you know, he's moving, but also his jaw is opening up a little bit as well. And we want to track the face because we're going to add kind of a texture or an effect to the face itself. So that's really why we're in Mocha, because it does a wonderful job of picking up even distortion. Oftentimes you don't want, you know, your object or what you're tracking to distort, but in this case, it does distort, so we want to pick that up. So we're just going to grab next spline here, and I'm just going to track right around the edge here of his face, and we don't need to go into the lips, and we know the finger is coming in here, so we'll avoid that area. And I'm going to turn on perspective, and then we'll just go ahead and track forward. Okay, so now that our track is done, we can see just by scrubbing through that it is picking up the movement in the jaw. As the jaw opens and wiggles a little bit, the track is picking that up. Let's go ahead and turn on our surface, and as of right now, this blue surface is where the data is basically what's going to carry over into After Effects. And so this isn't quite enough of an area to work with. We're going to want to add some veins to his entire face. So if we just extend this area out and make it a little bit larger, then we will have more area to work with. Whatever's in the blue is going to be our canvas. Oops, not adjusting the X spline. All right, and we'll keep it relatively square as best we can. So now, as we go over into After Effects, it's going to be all that's in the blue. And we can just kind of apply a grid to take a quick look and see how it's looking. And out on the edges here, there's a little bit of a wobble, but I think since this is such a minimal effect, it's very, you know, it's almost hidden. It should almost barely be noticeable what we're doing. We should be A-okay. All right, let's go ahead and export our tracking data. And we're going to want to choose After Effects Corner Pin, supports RedGiant Warp and Mocha Import, and we will save that. I'll save it as CP, Corner Pin, and Healing. Overwrite, that's fine. All right, let's switch over to After Effects, and we're actually going to be using Mocha Import. We have some other tutorials here on AETuts that use this. Matthias recently did an awesome webinar really walking through some of the features of Mocha Import. It's really, really worth the purchase if you are planning on doing any extensive tracking. Some of the options, well, even the option we're going to be using today, really speeds up the workflow. If you don't have the money right off the bat, you can at least play around with it. I think for 14 days is what I want to say. And so there's a link here on this post. But give it a whirl, and if you can work it in your budget, definitely worth the acquisition. Okay, so we're back here in After Effects. I'm going to duplicate my footage right off the bat because this bottom one's going to be my original footage, and then I'm going to apply the tracking data to this top one. And let's grab Mocha Import here, and I'm going to load that data, and let's go back to right here. All right, Corner Pin Healing. I want to start at the very beginning of my clip because that's where we tracked. Okay, and I want to come down here to Create Undistorted and Stabilized Precomp. We'll click that, and then we'll hit Apply. Let it do its thing. Okay, and now we can get rid of that. And if you look at it, it almost looks like there's nothing that happened to the footage. However, if we get rid of our background, we can see that we now have this moving comp. It's actually a pre-comp, and it's tracked perfectly to line up. We actually, if we double click, now we have a full frame version of this shot, which I'll do a quick RAM preview. Stays beautifully lined up, and it'll allow us to work on this. Let me just do a quick example. If I create a new solid, and I'll just create a little round dot here, then I go back to my original, turn it back on. As I do a RAM preview, you'll be able to see that this black hole is now tracked perfectly to his face. So you can see the options here. Matthias actually a while back had done a tutorial on how to do a head scar, and so using very pretty much the exact same concept. But you can see that there are lots of options for adding a scar, adding whatever you want, really, teeth or whatnot, a tattoo. And so using this concept, we're now going to, I just want to make sure we're on the same page for this. Now let's go in and I'll just get rid of my mask, but I'm actually going to use this solid. And I wanted to apply some veins. So initially I was thinking, well, initially I went and did a Google image search and looked for, I thought maybe I could find a stock photo of some veins. Just not a pleasant image search, I'll be honest. I thought maybe I could pull something in, but it's not worth it. And so then I thought, okay, maybe some lightning might look kind of cool. So, oops, lightning. So applying advanced lightning, I thought, okay, this could be kind of neat. Maybe I can get this to work if I take the glow down. But really, it's just a little bit too much detail, and I'm sure you could play around with the parameters enough to make it work. But it still wasn't quite what I wanted. So then, playing a little bit further, I came across cell pattern, and I thought this is cool. This has some potential. By just manipulating, I mean, I guess what this does is it just kind of creates all these little shaded spheres that have different options that you can manipulate, plates and I've used this for other stuff in the past. But if I move all the way down here to tubular, it kind of It, I, there's potential here. So let's play around a little bit with the settings. If I take my contrast, I knock it way down. Let's knock it down to 25. You can start to see how all these yellow or these white blobs are kind of leaving the black space. It almost kind of creates a little bit of a vein-like result. If we can, let's up the dispersion a little bit just to make it a little more boxy, and we'll scale this up just a little bit more. You can shift it to get a good result, but you can see how we're starting to get some nice veins here. Then let's take our transfer mode and we'll change it from normal to multiply. And now it's going to overlay nicely. Anything that was white will be gone, and everything that's darker than 50% gray will shine through. So we're getting a nice result. The lightning was a little too harsh. Here it's there, and then it kind of just feathers out naturally, kind of looking like there's actually darkness going through the veins here. Okay, we can tone this down maybe to just 50% for now, and what we want to do is create a mask. Obviously it's going over the eye and everything else, so let's take our pen and we'll just kind of cut around the outline a little bit here. And go along the cheek and the mouth and the eye, and maybe we'll kind of try to avoid that finger as it comes in. And I'm going to take cell pattern off for just a second so I can see what my feather is going to look like. Hitting F for feather, we'll bring that up and maybe not go too crazy with it, but that should work. Hitting M again to bring up my mask path. I just want to, and actually, I'm going to turn my opacity up just a little more so I can see what I'm doing. I want to keyframe it so that the feathered edge kind of stays with my face as I'm moving along and avoiding, the eye and everything. Okay. And overall, pretty decent. And that should suffice for what we're doing. Again, going back to our original, now we kind of have a Barney Rubble, scruff there. Pretty heavy 5 o'clock shadow. Okay, so we turn our cell pattern back on, and we have, let's get rid of the eye a little bit. A little too strong there. Do the same thing there. Okay, and you can take it another step, and if you wanted to actually cut out the little tube there, you can do that. But again, I'm gonna take it so minimally, maybe 40%, a little more than that, maybe 50. It should just be really subdued here. Okay, let's take a look and see how we're looking here. Okay, and it's stretching real nicely. Again, you can see where it's fading out in the neck. I probably could have extended the surface in Mocha so that the blue went all the way down to here to extend it down, but you're getting the principle. Okay, not too bad. It still looks a little bit too forced, or too, I guess, uniform. If I solo this, you can see that it still is, just the plug-in applied. Let's go ahead and let's distort this just a little bit. I'm going to apply a liquify, and I'm going to kind of bend it to the contours of his face. If I turn my brush size up considerably here, maybe not that considerably, I can just kind of, and let's even go down just a little further than that. It's going to be harder in the center. I'm just going to kind of bend it just to make it look like it's maybe wrapping around his chin, and we'll expand the cheeks out a little bit. I just want to make it look more believable. So if it looks as though it's actually round on his cheek rather than just kind of this flat, veiny texture, hopefully it'll sell it a little bit more. Okay, let's back out. Oops. And let's turn that on and off. And we can do a little bit more maybe there. Okay. Again, just looking at it before and after. Nothing too over the top crazy, but I think that little bit might kind of make it feel. I don't care for that one. So at any point, if it's just this isn't really working, we can just maybe shift the evolution a little bit, and that'll shimmy things around. If you ever get like a really hard vein in one particular spot, you can adjust that. Okay, not bad. The next thing I want to do is I want to have it actually animate with the touch. So as the finger kind of comes on here, let's see here. Okay, this is right where it touches. I'm going to create a secondary mask. So let's just create a little circle here, and I'll do it right where the finger is going to touch. And if I bring up my mask path, it starts there, and then as I move forward a little bit, I can just grab these points. Oops. Grab these points, and I'll just expand it out because I want for when he touches, I want for the veins to kind of grow into place as if it's, he's sucking the energy right out of the guy, whoever this archangel of death is. No good. Okay, and I'm going to create one more there because I feel like this is going to be a little bit too uniform. So as it's backing up, let's maybe bend it in so that it's not just a perfect circle going out. Okay, we'll move that right about there, and then we'll extend that out further and then tuck these guys in. It's just going to make it so as it grows on, it feels a little bit more organic and natural. Maybe creating one more point. Sorry for the motorcycler. Oh, yeah, we'll go ahead and save this vein project. Okay. So now you can see. All right, and then just it's coming on more organically. Let's change this transform or this mask to intersect, which just means that now it's only going to show what is, where both of the masks overlap. And again, I'm going to turn off cell pattern and liquify just so that I can see this secondary feather here. Not too much, but enough to keep things soft.
Okay.
And let's give that one a whirl. Back in our main comp. See how it's looking. Okay. Still a little rigid here as it comes on. We can tweak those things accordingly. The last thing that I would probably do is, as we are sucking the energy out of this guy, I would probably want to, you know, maybe suck the color out of his face a little bit. So we could, again, I probably ought to have extended the shot all the way down so I could have gotten it. Two ways of doing it. If we want it to track perfectly to our face, I can just create a new adjustment layer. And then if you grab the rounded rectangle tool, you can click and then hold. Realize that as you are still holding, if you hit left, it'll square it up, and then right will round corners to wherever you are. Again, I'm still holding down the keypad. If I drag it out further at this point, it's going to keep the rounded edges where I hit the right arrow key. Again, I can hit left square and then round, and it'll round it to that point. So I just want to find a nice roundness, let's say maybe here, and then I will extend it out at that point. Okay, and here I can extend. I can apply maybe a tint, and I'll go 15%, a little more than that, maybe 25. Okay, and I'll feather this out. Now this isn't going to look perfect, just because I'm feathering it out, and you can still see the color in his neck there. If I didn't have the feather, it would be a pretty hard edge. Oops, as I undo. So that's one way we could do it, is actually apply it to the face itself. But in this case, since I didn't do the full surface, what I would honestly just do is take my adjustment layer and bring it in here. I'll kill it, bring it in here, and then get rid of my mask. And right as soon as the vein starts kind of coming in, again, I apologize for the motorcycles going by, I would just kind of create a nice mask path right here, which will then only apply to his face. So it keeps, and we can feather that. So then you can see, turning it off and on, I'm slowly killing the color and muting it. So I will take this opacity and bring it forward there and make it nothing there. So then now as he goes forward, it will slowly suck that. Again, obviously we're gonna have to keyframe our mask path. Okay, well, I hope this gives you a couple of ideas as far as some different effects that you could pull off. Next time you need to recreate some veins, maybe consider the cell pattern. And if you ever need to track something to someone, that especially if they're moving, you know, using Mocha import with the stabilized precomp is a good solution. So until next time, this is Adam Evermiller for AETestPlus.com, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.